There are several syntactical tricks available to make closure expressions super concise. In fact, this is one of the coolest aspects of closure expressions in Swift, and at times, one of the most confounding. I want to walk you through some of these tricks using the filter method from the array class. The filter method is called by an instance of the array class. It takes in a condition as an argument and returns an array that's been filtered based on that condition. The condition is passed in as a closure. Here I have an array of exam grades, and I'm going to filter this array for all the grades above 70. We'll call those grades passing grades. So I call the filter method with the object exam grades, and I pass in a closure representing the filter condition. The closure takes in a grade, an int, and returns a bool representing whether the condition is true. At this point, this looks a lot like the syntax we saw for sort. Here's the first trick. The compiler can infer closure expression types based on what parameter type a given function expects. In this case, the compiler can infer that the closure expression for filter will take in a parameter that matches the type of the array being filtered. The compiler can also infer that this closure will return a bool. So here, we can leave out the word int, and we can leave out the word bool, and over here in the sidebar, you can see that we still get the same result. On to the next trick. If a closure is a single expression like this one, it can be inferred that the result of that expression should be returned, so we can remove the word return. And again, over here in the sidebar, you can see that our filter still works. And now for the trick that's been known to make some code readers' heads spin, shorthand argument names. Swift provides default argument names for closure expressions. So instead of specifying a first argument, the first argument is known as $0, the second argument is known as $1, and so on. So here, for example, we don't have to give this argument a name, we don't have to use the name grade, we can just use the default name for the first argument, $0. And since we're not giving grade a name anymore, we can omit it here as well, along with the word in. Let's see all those shortcuts one more time. We'll go back to the alphabetical soup example from your quiz. The closure expression parameter and return types can be inferred, so we can take out string, string, and bool, along with the arrow, of course. This is a single expression closure, so it can be inferred that it returns the result of the single expression, so we can leave out return, and we can use shorthand argument names for soup1 and soup2. And we're left with a statement that truly is amazingly concise.